If you're taking multiple medicines, have you heard of medicine interactions? Because it could affect how well they work. I'm going to teach you 5 simple tips to help avoid them.
So, you see these books, and these, and this, and this, and all these? I think we've got it. So pharmacists study these types of books at university so we can fully understand why and how medicines interact. Now what I'm not going to do is give you specific interactions and explain why they happen, because we'll be here forever. But what I will do is give you a basic knowledge of how medicines interact, and then we'll move on to tips. So when we say medicines interaction, it doesn't mean that they combine in the body and cause a chemical reaction of some sort. In fact, here's a simplified version of what medicines interaction means.
A drug, supplement, or food can affect the absorption of a drug in our body, its distribution, breakdown, and excretion. So because of this interaction, the level of drug that's in our body can either increase or decrease. And I hope that made sense. So, medication interactions can be very dangerous. Let's say, for example, you take a medicine that helps to thin the blood, and you take another medicine, or a herbal remedy, or a supplement, or a food, and it interacts with it. And it suddenly increases its level. So you're suddenly at a higher risk of bleeding. Or it reduces its level and you're suddenly at a higher risk of having a clot. Now it's unrealistic for patients to memorize every single interaction with their medicines. But following these simple tips can go a long way. Tip 1, know exactly why you're taking each medicine. Let's face it, drug names can be very difficult to pronounce, and if you're listing your medicines to a healthcare professional, and let's say you say it incorrectly, then a potential interaction could go unnoticed. So I thought I'd give you 3 of my favourite mispronunciations. First, I've got Lanzarote instead of Lansoprazole, Amplodipine instead of Amlodipine, and Ramiprilo, which I call it the Italian version of saying Ramipril. Which actually got me thinking, if there's any healthcare professionals watching, leave a comment below with your favourite mispronunciation, because we could potentially do a future video on this. Now back to tip 1, so if you say the name of the medicine followed by why you actually take it, the healthcare professional is much more likely to know which medication you're on and be able to check for interactions with current medication that you're taking. Now if you're going to find it difficult to remember or you're taking a few different medicines, you can always ask your pharmacy to add the reason why you're taking it on the pharmacy label that they stick on, or instead, you can carry a repeat medication list with you, but make sure it's up to date. Tip 2. Know how to take your medication. So should it be taken with food, on an empty stomach, or should you avoid any certain types of food, like dairy for example? If you're not taking it right, it can reduce its absorption, its effectiveness, or even cause irritation of the stomach lining. Now this information can be found in the patient information leaflet, which comes with every medicine, the pharmacy dispensing label, or just ask your pharmacist. They'll tell you everything you need to know. I've also left a link in the description below where you can search each medicine and find out more information. Tip 3. Let your pharmacy know about all the medicines that you take. Pharmacies don't have access to your medical records, so if you've been started on a new medication, they may not know about it. So when your pharmacist hands your medicines to you, let them know about it, and they might be able to give you some really useful tips so you can get the most out of your medicine. Which brings us on nicely to tip 4. Supplements, herbal remedies, over-the-counter medicines, these can all again interact with your medication. So let your healthcare professional know so they can check for interactions. Tip 5. Speak to your amazing pharmacist. I always ask patients to bring in all their medicines, so either a list or actually bring them into the pharmacy. So their prescribed medicines, non-prescribed medicines, herbal remedies, supplements, bring in everything. And then we can sit down and have a look at them and identify any interactions between them and give you the best advice so you can get the most out of your medicines. And by the way, this is something that all pharmacists will happily do for their patients. So utilize their expertise and get the most out of your medication. Medication interactions are a very serious issue, and hopefully these simple precautions will help to reduce them. And if you know anyone who takes medication who'll probably find this information useful, then share what you've learnt with them today. Or if that takes too long, just share the video with them. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.
To be honest, I'm more of a dog person, but...
5 simple tips to try. Oh, that was so good as well.
It's really warm here today.